This is so bad. I don't even want to tell them. Don't even put this on. I'm serious. Cut it out, because I don't want my wife to freaking know this. That if we'd go to like a barbecue function or anything, I didn't want people to see that I'd overeat at the function. So before I came home to pick up my wife, I'd go get fast food and fill up on fast food to go to the party so I could eat a normal meal at the party. But I'm eating two meals within the same hour. And I would do that because I didn't want people to see me stuff my face at the party. So I'd eat twice. For a couple years, I'd do that. I'm not eating double meals, but really the only difference between when I was 268 previous and let's say the last year is that where I might have ate like that 5 days a week, 6 days a week, it's maybe 1 or 2 days a week where I really lose it. I'd say 3 to 4 days a week, I've been able to try to eat at least 2 out of 3 decent meals. So not completely fucked up, but out of a week, 1 or 2 days, if you really hit the, you know, the buffet and just freaking mack that shit. So it's like half the bad habits have crept in. I mean, that's the depressing part, is there's signs that I could do it and I just was struggling. I was just like frozen in time. I knew what I should be doing and I didn't. And it's sad that it takes the fall of your marriage to wake your shit up. But, I mean, here we are.
Have you been CrossFitting? Tell me about your fitness and your health.
What's stopping you from being the guy that goes home and changes your life?
It's time for him to, like, reinvent himself again.
Officially divorced.
Hi, Samar.
Hi, how are you?
She has zero say in your involvement with Tinder.
Is Tinder that easy?
Have you ate anything or had anything to drink that you didn't send me?
I took a sip of my mom's Coke.
Holy shit.
I know.
Have you talked to Anise in the last 48 hours?
I sent her a picture of my new girlfriend. Do you know when we're done with this, people are going to hate me?
No, don't listen to Tyson. Are you kidding? People are going to look up to you. People are going to be like, oh my God, I'm going to leave my wife, get an RV, get on Tinder, and...
CrossFit. It has been literally a fountain of youth. Bow, bow, chuk, 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 bow, bow, chuk, chuk, bow. We are at Santa Cruz Ranch RV in Santa Cruz, California, at Mi Casa.
And is this your home? Or are you on vacation?
No, this is my home. I live in this beast.
Tell me about that. Tell me how you ended up in a fifth wheel.
Well, my daughter, she graduated high school and immediately started talking about moving out. You know, it must be understood that for the entirety of my daughter's life, my wife and I, every decision we made was for her. Where you live, what you do, where you work. And I encouraged her not to move out. I was like, don't move out. It's cheaper if you live at home. But she insisted she wanted to fly the coop. So at that time, I thought it'd be a good opportunity to, at the same time, we were downsizing our house because we had no more kids there. And I thought, hey, let's put all our stuff in storage. At that time, I was just going to buy a little trailer and drive around the country. I've done all the traveling throughout my marriage. My wife mostly stayed home. So I thought it was kind of unfair. Over the years, there was a little resentment. And so I thought it was a great opportunity for her to see more of the country. And then I would just work on the road. This January would be 2 years, so I'm 4 months shy of 2 years since I've had this. So we're getting into that part?
I think we need to.
Well, a week before the CrossFit Games, I was assisting the missus into upgrading her phone, and she was acting really weird. And she ended up going to the store, and of course, Nobody likes this, but I got Snoopy, and I snooped into her messages, and I saw that she was talking. Nothing inappropriate. She's a legit girl. Just stuff like, you know, he said, I told my family, I will marry you. It's the last thing I do, or something like that. And she's like, oh, like, okay, where would we get married, or something like that.
You were snooping her phone and you saw a guy was writing this to her?
Not just any guy. Her high school love of her life. A story cannot be told that he broke up with her days before I met her. And so she never really coped with that breakup. And then I came in and I fell in love with her like instantly, swooped her off her feet, and I told her I was gonna marry her. And so it kind of like swept under the rug her heartbreak from this high school boyfriend. So he
what
comes.
What happened between them?
Their relationship was, they'd pass notes in high school talking about what are we gonna name our children and when are we gonna get married. And I mean, they were thinking that ahead, family, children, everything. Well, in high school, she kind of got spooked. Wait a minute, I'm not gonna have any sowing of any oats or not living life. Is this it, one man? So she kind of broke up with him. And then he spent a year chasing her around, and she did kind of live a little, had a few boyfriends, going out, having fun. And he talked her into finally getting her back. He's like, he was in the Air Force at that time, and he said, come to Washington, let's get married. And she said, okay, I will.
Did they have a wedding date scheduled?
No, he just said, come to Washington and we'll get married. You know, no dates.
But didn't he go black on her?
Yeah, he disappeared for a few days and she couldn't get a hold of him. And then she finally got a hold of him. She's like, where have you been? And he got cold feet. He said, I'm not sure if this is the right thing to do. So he essentially spent a year trying to talk her into getting back to her. When she finally agreed to go back, he changed his mind.
And that's when you swooped in.
And that's when I swooped in. I met her, and he called 2 weeks after we met, and he said, I made a mistake. I'm an idiot. And I took the phone away from her, and I said, buddy, you fucked up. We're getting married. You made a great mistake. And I hung up the phone. I was so confident in my relationship, I didn't look at him as a threat. So I said, he can come to the wedding.
Did he try to sabotage the wedding?
He did. He hung out with her a day before the wedding and tried to talk her into not marrying me, but he didn't know that we were already married. We had two weddings. I mean, we married 3 months after meeting each other, didn't tell anybody because no one wanted us to get married, and I was getting ready to go overseas, and I was scared that if I went overseas without being married to her, that I'd lose her. So when we actually had our, like, pretend wedding with everyone coming, we'd already been married for a year. She brought cupcakes to the barracks, and every Marine was like, dude, that's the greatest woman I've ever met. You need to marry her now. And before you go overseas, because if you don't get married before you go overseas, chicks disappear on you. You get the Dear John letter. And I was in love, yes, I was in love. But I was like, let's get married. She put on her prom dress. She literally put on her prom dress. We went down to I Do Weddings in Vista, California, and we got married. And you know, we're married 24 years, bro. We haven't really tied it back to the CrossFit, which we're going to. So don't forget to ask me about that, because CrossFit is important in terms of what happened before.
Gary Roberts has been here for a week now. Basically, we've been talking, and it's time for him to like reinvent himself again. He started doing CrossFit 6 years ago. He had a great run, and then he's sort of fallen off the wagon, and life's had its way with him. You really think he should do Laredo? How many times have you worked out?
What was the last thing you did?
The workout of the day is Laredo. It's a hero wad. It's 6 rounds of 24 squats, 24 push-ups, 24 walking lunges, and 400 meter run. And Sevan said to do scale that for beginners, and even the CrossFit wad site says just 4 rounds. And Sevan thinks that's still too much. But these movements, if I go to failure on push-ups, you know, I'm not gonna hurt myself too bad, right? I just have to slow down a little bit. So I'm gonna try 4 rounds, even though they think it's too much. So wish me luck, CrossFit World.
Tyson really is going to lead his 4-month recovery, and the prescription for the recovery is going to be CrossFit. And then to keep it interesting, not only are we going to document it, but Gary's been nice enough to give us some insight on sort of what's brought him to this situation today where he hasn't done CrossFit for 2 years. He's going to give us an intimate look at some of the complications that life throws at you.
Exactly. His name is Dave.
Okay, so you see messages?
I see messages, and it's not inappropriate, it's just flirtation. But he was clearly interested, and she was liking it. It'd been going on 2 weeks, and she wasn't hiding it from me. She told me they'd been chatting, but I didn't ask any details. I wasn't worried. It wasn't until she started acting weird that I got interested. You know, I could see where the path it was going, where like she was feeling something and she was not gonna wanna tell me about it, and then that maybe would blossom into something more, and then I would just be left in the dark. You know, how traditional affairs happen or whatever. And I was like, nah, well, let's not do that. So I pulled her aside and I was like, okay, I'm sorry, I snooped at your phone, but okay, I see you're heavily into the fact that Dave is into you. How does it feel talking to him? And she basically said it was like high school all over again, had all these feelings rushing back to her, and you know, love-like feelings. And I was like, I encouraged her to have a hall pass. That sounds stupid, but they hadn't officially scheduled a visit. They obviously were saying like, hey, I'd like to get together. She'd mentioned something like, he's going out of town. And I ran up, I said, were you gonna meet him without telling me? And she's like, I hadn't figured it out yet. She was still very new to her, this feeling. She was just excited about talking to him and obviously wanted to see him. So I told her, you have my full permission to meet. And she told Dave that, and he didn't believe it. She's like, he doesn't believe you. He thinks you're playing some sort of game. It must be said that the first thing he asked her was, are you happy? The second thing he said was, breaking up with you is the biggest mistake of my life. He has some kids and can't say your life is horrible, but in a romantic aspect, he was saying it was the biggest mistake of his life, and that he's gonna tell her that for the rest of his life, that he wants her.
What happened to him and his wife? Where's his wife?
Dave and his wife got a divorce the previous year, and I'm not comfortable talking about their story. I got on the phone with him, and I said, hey, Dave, what's up? Anissa said you didn't believe it, and I am saying, I want Anissa to be happy, and if it's with you, oh, because when he asked her on the phone, are you happy, she said no. Obviously, that's like a punch in the gut, but I told him, if she'd be happier with you, then I want her to follow her heart. It's crazy. Everyone's like, you're fucking stupid for saying that.
Someone told you that you're fucking stupid?
Yeah, a lot of people told me I'm stupid. But I just told them, my friends, family, everyone's like, I want her to be happy. And at this moment in my life, I sold the fuck out of myself when I first met her. I mean, I was probably gonna be a multi-millionaire, successful, like, life is no problem. Here we've been married 24 years and still, at times, struggling. So as a man, I wasn't feeling exactly full and whole at the moment. I was kind of down on myself, and he seemed to be doing pretty good, and I was like, hey man, if those feelings are there and you could give her a better life than I can, I'm not gonna hold her from that. Before this whole time building up, for some reason it's not hitting me, either a reality, like I'm emotionally handling what I said, like, okay, that's not this big a deal. I even told her, take your time. I even gave her permission to see both of us, be married and have a relationship with him on the side to make sure, because I was like, you don't know him, I take your time. Oh, her whole argument before the CrossFit Games was, listen, man, I don't know if this is gonna be real or not. I have these feelings, but as far as I know, is the minute I see him, it could be like, oh, never mind, there's nothing there. So don't get too carried away. And I was trying to tell her, nah, I got a feeling in my stomach that our shit is over. I think it was Tuesday at the CrossFit Games, so we were just getting set up, and I asked her, so you've met him, how was it? And she basically said it was just like high school all over again, and that didn't look good for me. So. I don't know if she uses those words, but something along the lines. The next day, I said, did you kiss him? And she said, no. And I said, did you want to kiss him? And she said, yes. And I said, he didn't try to kiss you. And she said, no. And I said, well, you should kiss him. I've always loved the opinion, you can tell by the kiss. A magical kiss will tell you a lot.
Are you trying to sabotage this relationship?
Yes, you're saying, did you sabotage your relationship? But it must be understood that we married after just a couple months. And then we had a kid within a couple years. And I came from a divorced family. I never wanted to be separated. And I realized really quickly that had we dated for probably like 3 years, her and I may have never gotten married. Probably almost ended up divorced maybe 3 or 4 times. But in the end, every time it came back to our kid, we were best friends. But when it came to like, say, were we lovers and were we happily married? Yes, it could be argued that we weren't. And no one can say we didn't give it our all to try to make it through that shit. When you're saying like, are you sabotaging our marriage? It's like, I have these thoughts and feelings throughout our marriage that where are we meant to be together? I love her dearly, but was she meant to be with somebody else? Was she meant to be with this guy? And now, because our marriage is like always in an ebb and flow, like an up and down situation, how can we stay happily married if she always has this idea of what if, you know, this guy comes back in her life and says, breaking up with you is the worst decision of my life and I love you. That's now a wedge in our relationship, and it can, if she doesn't find out if that's a real thing and on her own decides she wants to be with me, I mean, I saw no other choice than to tell you you should explore that. Okay, that's the thing, guys. I'm no innocent in here. Early on in the marriage, I strayed. When I realized, like, fuck, you know, she's always been the emotionally strong one. She's always been the smart one. She's always been the one that causes us to do the right decisions. I'm the one, always one who just freaking makes fucked up, stupid actions. And I did, you know, mess around earlier on in a relationship. She never did, I did. Even though we always found a way to come back for the kid to make it work, I still was the one that fantasized outside of the relationship. She didn't. So when this guy came back, Dave, maybe she needs to have that experience and get that out of her system, sort of thing. So that's why I encouraged it. When they kiss, I said, she's gonna fucking hate me for saying this. But I encouraged her. I said, did you kiss? She said, yes. And I said, well, did you want to do more? And she said, yes. So I said, you should do more.
So you were crying in the...
I was crying in the hall, yeah.
Why are you getting real-time feedback? That's how close you guys are? Tell me about that.
I like to know shit, and I asked her how, you know, I just asked her details about stuff, and she was not comfortable with sharing, but I thought I can handle something, and then when it actually came to reality, I was not equipped emotionally to handle it. I was like a weak little bitch.
What hurts?
Oh, I got a cramp.
Where?
Right here.
Tell me what the scene is like when you come back.
So the whole thing is, before the games, I encouraged her to make a slower decision. Then at the games, she's like, holy shit, this is real. I feel it. And I'm sorry. You encouraged me to go with my heart. And so I am. And so she's like, okay, I'm going to do it. And that, so I was taken aback by how easily, I wasn't discarded, but no, I think if I was in the shape I was after the first season of Killing Fat Man, I don't think she would have been able to leave as quickly. So when I came back from the games, I was an emotional wreck, I was crying, and she was pretty cold, She's like, hey buddy, you're gonna have to find another shoulder to cry on. She's like, I'm crying on the inside, but I can't cry with you. You need to mourn somewhere else because I'm trying to be strong for the both of us. And the funny part is that you basically messaged me saying, hey, what's happening? You said you didn't think she'd really leave. And then when I told you she did leave, and then you said, hey, come to Santa Cruz and do CrossFit, I called her up. And I said, so I'm telling you, she'd been cold and distant that whole week I came back from the games. And I called her and I said, I'm going to Santa Cruz. I'm going to work out at HQ and I'm going to get fit again. And she started crying. She literally started crying. And I said, no, you're not allowed to be cold for an entire week. And then when I tell you I'm leaving, you start getting teary-eyed.
He did Laredo yesterday, so I don't want him to do this again. So I think I'm gonna have him row and do like a dumbbell alternating dumbbell snatch.
Tap the ground.
Everyone ready?
There you go. Okay. I'm gonna have you pace off the bottom.
Okay.
You're gonna row until you see him come back, and you're gonna do 20 alternating snatches.
Okay.
Actually, you're gonna snatch until he heads out on his next run, and then you're gonna row again.
Okay.
So you're just gonna alternating snatches while he's working, and then hop on the row.
Dude, this is gonna be 30 minutes.
Yeah, that's fine.
We'll see how it goes. Be prepared. We might call an audible during the workout.
Call an audible. That's awesome. It got a little hairy because she doesn't like how she was portrayed in season one. Like, she was shallow and she didn't start liking me until I started doing CrossFit and gotten sexy and you look more doable. And I would like to defend her. It's not just that I looked better. It's that I just became a better human.
The first thing I really noticed and I kept saying to him was, gosh, thanks for being so helpful. Gosh, thanks for pitching in. Gosh, thanks. You've been really nice lately.
This has all unfolded in really the last 30 days.
Yeah.
Where is she now?
She is 2 weeks away from moving to New Mexico to be with the...
Is she moving in with Dave?
Yeah. She's really gonna hate... I don't think she wants all this business out there, but...
Why do you think she cares? What would she care?
People are gonna judge her for the situation, but I want them not to because she's awesome, she's an amazing person, and if she has feelings for Dave that she never had for me, then she should be with him.
Do you think she's gonna come back to you?
No.
Do you want that?
Man, I struggle with that. I've cried off and on, and I don't know if it's because of mourning the loss of my relationship or the fear of the unknown. Like, you know, she's been there, and we've tackled problems in the world together, and I'm really scared of the unknown, the world, and I'm a little fearful. I hope someone starts running soon. This trailer was meant for both of us, and she's not in it. Thank you. I don't want to get a spin like, oh, I need somebody. You know, you hear people say, oh, you can't be alone. Like, you need to prove to yourself you can't be alone. I have had somebody with me for 24 years, and now I don't. It is fucking a little nervous. I want all of those feelings back where I was proud of myself, where I accomplished something. I mean, every day you're pushing yourself, like today's workout, I was friggin' dying. But it's like at the end of the day, you feel that's a small goal that you've accomplished something. When you step away from CrossFit and then you let the uncontrollables of life beat you down and you don't have those little small goals, help pick you up and motivate you and prove to you that, yeah, you can fucking do this. I need that again because it really did help in other areas of life. Life got better when I proved to myself that I can do this and that I can hit it hard and that I can be a fit, stronger human. Honestly, I was scared of coming to HQ because I've never worked with everyone. I've only seen them at the games. And to be honest, all you guys are fit motherfuckers, and I was kind of intimidated, and I thought, you fucked me.
Yeah, you're gonna do great.
He's got another round.
You're gonna do great.
I've been fucked.
Fuck you.
He said that was his last.
No, it's good for you.
And the way you guys have embraced me and encouraged me that I can do this has just been very heartwarming. And it's helped me get over some of the nervousness that I did have.
Give yourself another 20 seconds, then we'll pick it up. Get to a minute, then we'll pick it up. Let's go, buddy.
Let's go.
Let's go.
Six, seven.
Nice job, Gary.
Nice, Gary.
Nice, Lee.
Oh man, that one hurt. They said Sevan was on his last run, so I was like giving
that everything.
Hey, that was a mind trip. Oh boy, Eric.
How much different would it have been if you did it by yourself?
It wouldn't have been the same. No way. Totally different. When you're with people telling you like, hey man, more. You do more.
Yeah.
That was awesome, Gary.
Yeah, really, really good.
She can't be upset at you. You're being so fucking respectful of her, dude. You're being so fucking respectful of her.
I hope so.
Crazy respectful
like,
of her.
Like, almost, it almost creeps me out, actually, a little bit, if I'm honest with you.
Like, man, you're nice to her.
I already feel better. Have a little more pep in the step.
I'm gonna create a text thread. It's gonna be you, myself, and Sevan. You're gonna take a photo of everything you eat.
Oh shit.
I'm gonna outline the CrossFit prescription, which is to eat meats and vegetables, nuts and seeds, some fruit, little starch, and no sugar.
Oh!
We have the solution to chronic disease.